G'day, welcome back. It's Justin Hogg from RightSource. Week three of budgeting, we're really ripping into it now. This week we're going to talk about cash forecasting. And cash forecasting is something a lot of businesses don't do, which is a little confronting because you don't know where your cash is at. A lot of people are running along with their business and they don't know if it all ends in 4 weeks or 8 weeks or 12 weeks. They don't know. They just keep selling, keep moving, and that's how they run their business. So this week we're going to go through putting together a cash forecast, which will give you that foresight of where your cash is going and whether you'll still be here in 4 weeks or 8 weeks or 12 weeks. So I make it light a little bit that you won't know if you're going to be here 4 weeks or 8 weeks or 12 weeks, but this is really the point of cash forecasting. And it can be scary because a cash forecast, when it says you are going to run out of cash in 12 weeks time or 3 months time, however long you do your time frame, that's scary because if you run out of cash, you know that could be the end of your business. The important thing for doing here is that if you know in 12 weeks you're going to be out of cash doing what you're currently doing, it gives you 12 weeks to fix the problem. What a lot of businesses that do fail, what their problem is, they realize they're out of cash today. That's the first time they realize they're going to be out of cash, and you have no chance of changing your course when you find out now you're out of cash. So this is why doing a cash forecast, out of all the budgeting stuff I'll talk about, this is the most important thing. This is the first thing I started doing when I started my own business, and it's the first thing anyone who's running their own business should do just so they start understanding how things are fitting together. So if you'd like to do this together, we can do this together. I can send you through a template. Just click the link below and put in cash forecasting or the secret password bacon, because everything's better than bacon. And we can then sit through the video watching how we put it together and put together your own cash forecast for your business at the same time. Cool, let's get into it. Hey guys, so this is our cash forecast template. We're gonna push out a cash forecast today. Now, this is a template that should suit most businesses. It's designed to be high level because you don't want to get into too much detail with the cash forecast because it's a forecast. You don't know this is going to happen. It's really just giving you some guideposts. So simple cash forecast. It's got your dates along the top, some notes there so you can keep the notes if you want to keep going through it. It's then broken into your cash in and your cash out, and that's what we'll go through and fill in. So let's start with cash in. So your key customers, so type in who your key people you think you might be getting cash for. You don't have to do this. I just like to know, obviously, keep track of those customers that I've either done a big job for or that I know are going to be repetitive and make sure that they're coming in. So there's a couple of names. Now we just go, okay, well, Leaf Enterprises, so we've just done a job for them. That's been invoiced. We should get paid this week. We're planning to do something else a bit later, so we'll put that in there. And basically, we keep doing a monthly job and they'll invoice at the end of the month. Fire No One is a ongoing retainer, a weekly retainer we get. So we chuck that in. Health, now these guys, this is a client that we do one big off piece of work for. That's gonna get paid in November. So put that in. So that's roughly when we think our main suppliers, our main customers are gonna be paying us. And then obviously we might have an online portal where people can buy goods or services or videos or subscriptions. And that tends to flow in every week about the same amount. Not a big cash spinner, but that comes in every week. So we'll put that in. That's the cash you're expecting in. It'll be up and down, but that gives us a rough indication. So then you go, well, that's what's coming in. What are we spending? Number one, always on my list, wages. Make sure staff are paid. So say we're spending that much a week on staff. So you do a weekly pay run. So each week, that's what gets paid out. Now you have a look at your key suppliers. So rent for your building that you're in, you pay that monthly. Put that in. Power, which you happen to pay quarterly, it gets paid around there. Internet, very important in today's business to make sure your internet provider's paid. Ooh, not 5,000, let's do 500. And when you're doing this, this is really about you understanding how much you pay. So if you don't know these, I mean, I'm just putting these numbers in pretty quick in terms of being able to demonstrate how you put this together. But some of it might be going back to your accounts and looking, well, how much do I spend on this? Or when is this due? Insurance, now, again, so that's a good example. Well, a lot of people, I don't actually know when my insurance is due, or I don't know how much it is. That's great. This process allows you to question that, go away, have a look, come back, put it in. Now, in this example, we're gonna say we pay our insurance in June, so there's nothing to put in this cash forecast, but at least you know it's included by having it on the list here. So then your other supplier payments, now you might do a payment run every second week, and that takes care of all the other bits and pieces. So we'll just put that in as an estimate, runs around about that much. Now, you might know these figures again, you might not. As you continue to do this forecast, the other learning you'll get is understanding what chunks of money are going out and what are those timing that'll give you a bit more awareness of what's happening. Okay, so the last three here in the cash out are very important, because these are the ones that can be hidden to a lot of businesses in that you don't see them because they're not front of mind. Your people you see, your suppliers you see because they're the ones you do your business. So your tax and your super that is payable can quite often slip under the radar because we're paying that once a quarter or once a month and you don't actually have someone screaming at you to pay it. So it's quite important. It's up to you as a business owner. It's your responsibility to make sure this stuff is done. So it's good to put that in the cash forecast. So PAYG, we pay monthly. So we'll chuck the same amount in each month. BAS, we pay quarterly. And that'll be due around there. And super, again, we like to pay that, even though we don't need to pay that monthly. We could pay it quarterly. We like to put that into our employees' super accounts each month so that they get a little bit more benefit from it. So we'll chuck that in there as well. Now, obviously these numbers look a bit weird. That's because we haven't put our opening cash balance in. So that's the last step. We've got our cash in and cash out. Now, what's our cash balance? So say our cash balance at the moment in the bank account is 200K. There you go, that's your cash forecast. So you can now see that your net cash movement sometimes is positive, that we're getting more cash in than we're spending, and some weeks are negative. Some are more than others. Now, the important thing is that closing cash balance at the bottom doesn't go into negative. So if we only had, for example, $100,000 in the bank, no, that doesn't quite work, sorry. If we only had 50,000 in the bank, we ran out of cash in November. We get a little bit there, we might be able to scrape through there using the credit card maybe in October. But November we're 30,000 short. Now, that would mean we couldn't pay super or we couldn't pay our employees, so that's an issue. But knowing it now, we can make a difference. We can make a change. So whether that be changing the business, getting access to cash, because it's always easier going to a financial institution to ask for a short-term loan when you have money in the bank. If you don't have money in the bank and you ask for a loan, it can be a much more difficult conversation. Now, that then gives you a view of your business and an understanding of your cash availability into the future. And that way you can see that you'll still be around in December. So that's it, we've got a cash forecast. You now have a better insight, or can have a better insight into where your business is going from a cash perspective. Two things just to make clear. You might be making a profit in your business or forecasting a profit and your cash is still going down. That is completely normal and can definitely happen when your business is growing. Because if you're growing, you're buying more stock, you're getting more substance about your business, you have to pay for that before you make the profit. So quite often, businesses that are making a profit will actually lower their cash because they're growing, they're successful. The other thing is that your cash forecast may also be not as great as your profit because you're paying back debt. Quite often when you start a business, you might get a loan and you're paying that back. Paying that debt back will drain your cash but won't affect your profit. So don't feel like your budget that forecasts your profit has to equal your cash flow. They're two very different things, and they're managing two very different things. The other thing is, you'll notice when we did the cash forecast, the time frame we looked at really was only 8 to 12 weeks. The reason behind that is that if you go much further, especially when you're just in the early stages of your business, you really don't know what's going to happen in 3 months' time. So it's really getting to just, you're just guessing. So the value is that short term to start with. As you get more history in your business, more repeat customers, more of a feel of the flow of things, you might want to extend it, you might not. That's really up to you. The time frame, again, is very particular to you. So if you found this week's video interesting and useful, please hit the subscribe button. Just a reminder as well, if you'd like a copy of the template we used today to put together your own cash forecast, click the link below, put your details in, put in cash forecasting or the secret password bacon, and I'll flick that through to you straight away. Cool. Thanks. See you next week.